Colin Glenn.
Ah, good thing. And Daniel Kenny.
Paradise Ranch.
Wait.
We're gonna get crystals.
Supposed story. It's fake news.
But he sent a picture.
Fake news.
So.
They sent a picture of one they supposedly found, but that's it, not the hole they found him in or anything.
Found a quartz vein on his Paradise Ranch, and we're gonna go collect some crystals.
It's so golden right here, boys.
And we're also gonna talk about the new show,
Gold Rush Whitewater.
Yes. Yes. Very cool. But it's actually one of the shows I casted for, and I'm going to show you some clips of my casting. But we'll get back at you when we're at Paradise Ranch. Say hi to our baby boy, Ammo. He's our new boy. He's 8 months old.
He drooled up a storm.
He is. He's a drool.
In my ear right there. Super gross.
So I promised you some, promised I'd show you some of my casting for that Whitewater. Couple years ago it was 2016 when I casted for that part. And 2016 was a busy year. I think I was called to cast 5 different times. And I casted for 3 different shows. One of the shows made air, and my boy Goose got that part. I'm glad he did though, because I would have never been able to think about making fire and floating across a river. That was pretty gnarly, I gotta say. Hey, stop it. Anyways, so the other one I casted for finally came on show, and I didn't know anything about it. I didn't know that Dakota Boys had anything to do with it until they just started airing it. So. And when this project came around, Whitewater Gold, dredging, I can tell you, is one of my favorite things to do, but California has such strict mining laws. I haven't been able to do it for the last 5 to 7 years, and to hear you guys are doing this in the rivers of Alaska just got my heart pumping and ready to go. So what I can offer for y'all is my knowledge in gold prospecting. I'm all about finding that gold. I've been prospecting for about 12 years now, and that's what I do, just gold mining, gold prospecting, sluicing, and everything from high banking to dredging to dry washing to, I mean, everything except for everything small scale mining. I've never been into the big, large scale mining operations, so everything small scale. You could call it a family business. My dad and my uncle, they've been doing it since they were 20 years old. So they got 30 years, 60 years between the both of them. And, you know, growing up with my father and uncle, of course, they always took me out. And that's how I grew up doing it. That was our vacations, finding gold.
Cool. And like, this is pretty Yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah, I can hang with these guys. I can't imagine anyone that works harder than I do and is more dedicated at what the task in front of me I have. I mean, I get the job done, and I do not like to fail. So as for the wilderness, that's what I do on the weekends when I'm not forklift driving during the week trying to make money. On the weekends, I'm in the river. I'm camping in the river. Friday, I usually have Fridays off, so Thursday when I get off work, I'm gone. I'm up in the mountains. I don't come back till Sunday. I sleep in the rivers. I sleep in the woods. I don't think any of this is going to be a huge difference, except for the cold, because I'm from California, so that's the only thing that really makes me nervous. The zip lining, that's kept me up ever since I learned about this project. Eileen told me about the zip lining to work, and I haven't slept since because I'm so excited about that. The hiking, I hike weekly where I need to go. I usually hike 4 to 5 miles in, and I mean, I'm talking not on trails. I don't do many trails. I'm hiking, bushwhacking, and, you know, climbing over boulders the size of buses, and, you know, I'm not too sure Alaska's as gnarly as the California motherlode. Coldness, yeah, but the California motherlode's pretty rugged, and I think I'm ready for Alaska, with that being said.
Good deal.
California's great. The weather's great. The people not so much. But why would I leave California to go to the cold Alaska? I mean, California's great. Every weekend I'm up in the mountains prospecting, and it's 70 degrees, no shirt, sometimes in my underwear panning because I'm so deep in the rivers. But why would I leave this to go to Alaska? Because it's a lifetime experience. I've always wanted to go to Alaska. And when I heard dredging, I heard zipline, I heard tents, I was sold. It's a dream. Oh, the millennials. I used to be 25 one time, and I was young and dumb. There's a lot more going on in your mind than when you're that age. So I hope you guys go with me and not a young 25-year-old greenhorn that's probably going to bitch and complain, because that's what millennials do. And that's why you need someone who's seasoned, who's disciplined. I got police academy, force fighting. I've done it all. I've seen it all. And I'm ready to help you all.
That's the answer I'm looking for. That was perfect. Okay, great job, Josh.
All right. I'm trying to find the girls. They're getting crystals. I can't find them. Ammo! Find your mom. There's crystals and gold. on this property. It's quite amazing.
Oh, fuck you.
I had to get evidence of this place.
Although really when the dirt's this wet, it is the best time.
It is, yeah, I bet. Saved it.
Pretty good.
Excuse
me.
Quit it.
Oh, God.
Oh.
I know it's bro.
Look
at me smacking around.
Look at all these already. Okay, that one. That one's mine. That one's mine. That one's mine. Mine. When you see your rad swag, your shirt. Open it up.
Open it up.
Yeah.
Hey.
Rad swag.
Rad swag. Yeah. I'm a bad boy.
Tried so very hard to fill his shoes, working hours without rest, wanted me to have the best. She tried to raise me right, but I refused. And I turned 21 in prison, doing life without parole. No one could steer me right, but Mama tried, Mama tried, Mama tried to raise me better, but her pleading I denied. That leaves only
who's that? Who's coming?